also want to thank, actually, who I think had more of a impact than they know is Kara Levin for continuously telling the story about the need to close this gap and keeping the pulse on the legislature to make sure we did what we needed to do.
We have action to report tonight in the wake of a year-long Kara Levin investigation exposing deadly gaps in our state's mental health and criminal justice systems. The legislature passing a sweeping bipartisan reform bill to better treat people with mental illness and protect the public. Investigative reporter A.J. Legault is here with that update. A.J.?
Randy, when we started this gap investigation following the mass shooting and bombing at the Buffalo, Minnesota Medical Clinic, we called it a failure to treat, a failure to protect. Tonight, we can report our state did not fail to take action to seal the gaps we helped bring to light.
Messages from the Senate.
It was nip and tuck.
Herewith returned as amended by the Senate.
As close as could be cut.
It's coming to the floor at 11:54 at night on the last night of session.
Close calls, one way to put it. Mm-hmm, yeah. 3 minutes left.
Six. But who's counting?
Yeah, it was a close one.
But in the end,
and the clerk will take the roll on the bill.
Minutes shy of the legislative session's midnight deadline, lawmakers in both parties, in both the House and Senate, voted overwhelmingly to close gaps Kara Levin's investigation exposed, fueling murders, rapes, and violence, all while leaving vulnerable Minnesotans with mental illness without care and oversight.
This is going to save lives. Not a life, but lives. What was accomplished last night is life-changing for so many families.
Our investigation discovered in Minnesota, when a criminal defendant is found incompetent to go to trial because of mental illness, it's no one's job to help restore them to competency. So they're often just cut loose until there is another victim, like Abigail Simpson, or Tommy McCoy, or Paul Pfeiffer.
A change was done so that we can close this gap.
Maybe the tragic stories we've heard about will never happen again.
The new law creates a statewide competency restoration system, provides funding for 120 people whose job it will be to provide oversight and promote prevention and diversion to keep those with mental illness from re-entering the criminal justice system.
I think it's huge.
Sue Abderholden with the National Alliance on Mental Illness helps spearhead the reforms and calls them transformational.
So to have someone there that can be engaging with the person, making sure that they're in treatment, making sure that they're getting their needs met, stable housing, all of it, I think that's going to be huge.
The reforms also closed the gap our investigation exposed that allowed the accused Buffalo Clinic shooter to legally buy a gun despite a history of mental illness and criminal charges. For more details on exactly what this bill does, you can read my reporting partner Brandon Stahl's story on KaraLevin.com.